questions are big for the answers. We are poems awaiting the rhyme. We are riddles that long for solution. With your breath, we come alive. We are silence when searching for reasons. We are weary and broken inside. We are desperate for your affection. We are darkness, you are light.
Good evening. It's good to see you all here this evening. We've got a great service in store, so we want to go ahead and get started. We are thrilled to have Reba and Zach with us, as well as Jared, who I had not yet met. Apologize for that, Jared. I was back with the choir when they got here, but we are thrilled to have them with us. We're going to start with the song we'll sing together, and then we'll have our summer in Sac for the kids, and then we'll turn it over to them for their concert. But as they come, let's bow our heads for a moment of prayer to invite the Holy Spirit this evening. Dear Lord, we thank you for this evening, for this first Sunday of Advent, as we look with anticipation of the celebration of the coming of your Son to earth. Lord, we give you praise and thank you so much for Jesus, our Messiah, who you sent from heaven to earth to atone for our sins and to save us from death, Lord. We just want to give you praise tonight, Lord. May you open our hearts to what you would have to say to us through the music this evening. Amen.
Well, good evening. We are so excited to be here with you this evening to worship and kick off your Christmas season. Stand and worship with us. may be seated.
Good evening, boys and girls. Pastor Kim is not here tonight. You can tell that very well, can't you? And so we've got something different in that you didn't get to pick out a story. I did. And I picked out a story, and I've got some clues here in my sack. Not a pretty sack like Pastor Kim has. It's just a Walmart bag. But I've got some clues in it, and I want to show you a clue and see if you can guess the story that I want to tell you this evening. Here we go. One piece of wood. Luke, what do you think it is? Moses? You think it's about Moses? Okay. Grace? Noah and the ark. Nope. Someone else. Benson, you have an idea? Oh, well, that's a good story, but that's not what this is about. Got one stick. Okay. Is it a staff or a walking stick? No, it's not really either one of those. Let me get out another piece of... Okay, now I've got two pieces of wood. Any ideas? Yes. Let me give you another hint. Oh, a whole lot of hands have gone up. Evan, what do you think it is? About the cross. Okay, Jesus being crucified. And so we're right here at Christmas time, and we all celebrate the birth of Jesus, the Son of God. What's a good scripture that we think about Jesus' gift, God? Evan? If I gave you a scripture. That's exactly right. Would you step up here and say it on the microphone so people...
God so loved the world, he gave his one and only Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life.
Right. Thank you, Evan. That's a great job. You did well. And so when we see the cross, we think of the sacrifice that Jesus made by dying on the cross for our sins. And that is part of the story that I'm going to tell you, but I've got something else in my sack. I don't do much better with sacks than some of the little kids. Okay, I've got a stone. What would the stone have to do with it? Brooklyn? They stoned Jesus? Well, that's true. Mark? All right, Mark has the right answer. They rolled the stone away from Jesus' tomb. So the important thing is not the fact that Jesus was born at Christmas time, that we celebrate his birth at Christmas. That's important because he couldn't have come without being born. But then he died on the cross, and we all know that he died for our sins. God gave his only Son to die for our sins. And then after he died, he was put in the ground in a sepulcher, a grave. But on the third day, Jesus rose. The stone was rolled away, and Jesus lives today. And so we have the wonderful story that Jesus is alive, and he lives. And so when you think of Christmas, and you'll be thinking of Christmas, won't you? Have any of you thought anything about Christmas? Yeah, I thought so. As you think about Christmas, think of the marvelous gift that God gave us, His Son, and He lives today. All right, let's pray together. Pray with me. Heavenly Father, thank you for Jesus. Thank you that Jesus came to this earth. Thank you that Jesus died for our sins. Thank you that Jesus rose again. Thank you that Jesus lives in our hearts today. Help us to be good examples of your love. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. All right, two larger boys, help me. Austin and Evan. Pass out the candy.
Well, we are just super excited to be here with you guys tonight. It's so fun to see so many familiar faces and some new faces. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Reba Lassiter, and I was raised at Mustang Church, the Nazarene. And we're going to take you on a musical journey tonight. We're going to sing all kinds of styles and different types of Christmas songs. And if you can't find at least one you like, you're probably pretty picky because we're going to cover them all. But I thought it'd be fun to start out tonight with the song that started it all. Not in this building here, but across the street. My grandma loved to buy me soundtracks to sing when I was little. And the first one she ever bought, I was 4 years old. And I sang this in front of y'all's church across the street over there. So I thought it'd be only appropriate tonight to start with, "Do You Hear What I Hear?" Said the night wind to the little Well, as many of you know, I was here all the way through high school, and one of the greatest things that ever happened was upstairs in that youth room, our youth pastor gave me an opportunity, and he said, would you like to start help us develop a youth praise team? And we put together a little band and would play on Wednesday nights, and it was such a fun experience. Played with many of your kids that I see over here, and we had a great time, and that kind of continued to develop my musical interest, and was singing at Mustang High School and taking lessons because my grandma always made sure I got music lessons if I wanted them because she loved music. And I went to our university, Southern Nazarene, and after I'd only been there about a year, UConn First Church, the Nazarene, called one day and said, how would you like to come try to be our worship pastor? And I really didn't have a lot of experience besides playing with the youth here, but went over and fell in love with that job throughout college, and that's where I got introduced to Zach Sutton. He was in the youth group that time. We are not for sure, maybe 13-ish, 12-ish years old, and he said, I'm going to drag a keyboard out and put it on stage, and he sat behind the piano player and played, and a lot of Sundays he ended up playing when the piano player wasn't there. And so it was so fun that last year, I've ended up worshiping at different churches, and I've been at Norman a little bit, and Williams Memorial, and last fall, I was leading some at Norman, and they called, and they said, would you like to do a Christmas concert? And I said, sure, and I called Zach up, and he came right over, and so it was fun that we got to do that last year and join you this year, and bring along a friend, Jared, that you'll get to meet a little bit later. But I wanted to share a little bit more about it's been so fun to be able to develop this gift of music through the Nazarene Church, and I think it's so great how you guys involve the kids in the service, and you always allowed us opportunities to sing and develop, and my grandma continued to buy me all kinds of soundtracks as I was growing up, and some of them I would never sing in public ever again, some Lulu Roman, Ain't No Grave, all kinds of things, but one of them that she had bought me that I never actually sang until this year was Mary, Did You Know, and it's one of my favorites. I'd heard my aunt sing it multiple times, and so we began to think about what we wanted to do. I thought it would be fun to do that one for y'all, and you're going to get a chance to hear Jared in a second, and Zach will officially introduce him later.
Your baby boy would one day rule the
So I wanted to share a little bit about my time at SNU, because that was kind of when I didn't get to see you guys as much. We have a fantastic university, the Nazarene Church does. And what I really love the most about it is that the faculty and the staff and the classes and everything you go to work so hard in taking young people and helping them find who they are. The things that we've been taught in church, the things we've been taught by our parents and passed down, they help us really discover what it means to us and discover our own faith and our own styles. And that was really fun for me, especially to get introduced to a new styles of music. And one of the things that they did was I found that I loved the things that I'd always loved and had learned and been passed down through my family as far as musical styles, but there were some things that I just could find new ways to tweak things and new arrangements. And one of the songs that I loved to sing was Breath of Heaven. I sang it a lot. And my voice teacher one day said, I want to show you this arrangement of this song. It's called I'll Go Tell Elizabeth, and it's kind of the same thing as Breath of Heaven, a Mary song, but it was written by a man named Ken Medema that she met in New York City when she was there singing. And so she brought this back to us, and me and Zach picked it up last year, and it was so fun to learn it because we couldn't even find a recording of it anywhere to practice with. So I hope you guys enjoy this today. To me that I don't understand. Visions and angels, a baby named Jesus is not what I planned. Plans I have made are like bird's nests blown down by the wind and the rain. Scattered like straw, I can't quite tell where to find sameness again. Again, I'll go tell Elizabeth, she'll understand. I'll go tell Elizabeth, she'll hold my hand, she'll understand. Go talk to Joseph. Well, I've talked to Joseph, and Joseph's a man. So many things a woman can know that a man never can. Joseph is practical. Joseph is worried by things of his own. And talking with Joseph is sometimes no better than being alone. Being alone. I'll go tell Elizabeth. She'll understand. Now that she's pregnant, her life isn't going exactly as planned. Plans she has made are like bird's nests blown down by the wind and the rain. She's scattered like straw, she can't quite tell where to find sameness again. I'm coming, Elizabeth. Okay, so I'm going to turn it over to Zach and Jared for a little bit, and you guys are in for a treat. It's so fun to just hear how much Zach has changed and is playing over the last 7 or 8 years. And this guy is a talented musician and a great young man that UConn Nazarene Church has raised, and his parents who are kind of here tonight. And so I want to go ahead and turn it over to Zach.
Thank you very much. It's very good to be back, and I've been here a lot this year, and I like that. You all have always treated me nice, and it's really good to be back. Just want to make a little comment as far as what Reba said about me pulling the keyboard out and playing behind our piano player at church at the time. She made it sound a lot cooler than it actually was. I was just starting to learn to play by ear and to learn to read chord charts. And so I pulled that keyboard out and sat down behind the piano player that day, and they gave me the chord charts that they were going to use and just kind of walked off and let me do my thing. And so I legitimately had never seen a chord chart before. And so I sit down and, you know, I'm thinking, well, we're in the key of A. First chord is an A. It says an A on the page, right, above the measure where that A is supposed to be played. I just think an A. And that's all I played. I sat there that whole service and did little things like that because I didn't know any better. So I had to learn real quick because our piano player, he was kind of sickly, and he got sick a lot. And so Sunday mornings I'd show up and expect to, you know, just be able to sit behind him and kind of have a good time and not be up front. And he wouldn't show up, and Reed would turn to me and say, hey, you're on piano. I'd say, oh, great. But as you can tell, I learned how to read chord charts a little better and got over that. But once again, thank you for having us here tonight. I'd like to introduce the fellow over here on guitar. He's definitely one of the best guitar players in Oklahoma City and probably in the state, and my favorite to play with, and truly one of my best friends, which is the most important thing. And we share the love of music together, the love of several other things, fishing, hunting, whatever. He graduated from Southern Nazarene University with a degree in music business. So please give a warm welcome to Mr. Jared Gilreath. This next song that he's about to do is called One Christmas Night, and it was actually written by a guitar player as well named Tommy Emmanuel. So please enjoy. Thank you.
this morning I was kind of worried because I do a lot more talking in between the songs than Zach does. Ever since I've known him, he's been kind of quiet. But last night, my family's here with me today. We were having Thanksgiving, and we started playing this little game that has like trivia facts on it. And one of the facts we learned in the game was that on average, a woman says 4,200 more words per day than a man. So now I don't feel so bad about doing more talking than Zach. But he's talking more tonight, so it's good than he did this morning. I want to tell you that, you know, when I went to SNU, I was raised here on a farm in Mustang, rode my horse, and the only opera I'd ever heard about was the Grand Ole Opry, or the Oklahoma Opry. And when I got to school, my voice teacher said, I think that there's a bigger voice in there. We should learn some classical music. Like, here's some opera singers you should look up. And I didn't know anybody, didn't know any of these shows she was talking about. But I quickly fell in love with classical music and singing it and performing it, and even spent a little time away from SNU one summer performing an opera in the Ozarks. And so I brought a few classical things for you today, and I hope you enjoy them. Completely opposite than Jingle Bell Rock, but we're trying to cover all the types here. So the first song I'm gonna sing for you is called Yesu Bambino. I have to tell you a funny story. My family has slowly gotten used to me singing more classical music. It's a little different style than they're used to. But last Monday night, I had a small recital for the kids that I teased voice and piano to out of my home. And Zach came and played for my students. And then we did a couple of songs to practice for our concert. So we sang the Yesu Bambino in this next song we're about to sing. And everyone has gotten used to it in the family except for our rowdy. which Rowdy is my cousin's little one. And my sister tells me that he laid on the floor and covered his ears during those. But when he got back to Zach's fun music, he got up and said, "That's good." So the family's getting used to it. I'm so proud of him. He didn't cover his ears that time. So we're going to sing a lute carol next. I've had a really good time during this whole process of getting to know Jared, Zach's friend, and he's so good, so talented, that I had to do one with him. And so this is O Holy Night, accompanied by Jared.
Thank you.
As much as I hate to say it sometimes, I'm kind of like Rowdy, and I hear some classical songs that I've heard and just want to cover the ears, but not when Reba sings it. She always does a good job. I bet that everybody in this room could easily say that they have a memory that's attached to a song, or vice versa. We all agree? I think that's one of the coolest things about music is you can listen to a song and it takes you back. And sometimes it can seem so real, like reliving a memory. And I think that's one of the coolest things about the Christmas season. And so this next song we're going to do, I just want you to sit back and think of some warm Christmas memories as we do the Christmas song.
Thank you.
So I was thinking the other night, you know, when you're a little kid and you ask them what they want for Christmas, there's a long list of things, right? They can name off every toy and gadget that they want. And my husband asked me the same question the other night. He said, what do you want for Christmas? And I just, it was really hard to come up with a list. And I was thinking about that. You know, we've had a lot of change in our life last year. And some of you have been asking, what's new in my life? I did get married last fall. And he is not here with me today, him and his father. His father surprised him for a hunting trip for an early Christmas present. So they are down in South Texas hunting for the next few days. But we've moved closer to you guys. Actually, I feel like I live on the Nazarene Street. Many of you live on my street. So it's real fun. We live just over here in Canadian Estates. And I'm not involved in music ministry at the moment. My ministry has switched to women's ministry. And I mentor lots of women professionally and personally in a makeup business. And life is good. But you know, there's been a lot of changes. We lost my grandma last year. And so as I think about what we want for Christmas, this song, I just love it because so many times the things we want, money can't buy. And so I hope this is for all of you today, that maybe this Christmas, your list is heavy. You want someone to be healed. You want a family member to come home. So this is for you.
Do you remember me? I sat upon your knee. I wrote to you with childhood fantasies. Well, I'm all grown up now. Can you still help somehow? I'm not a child, but my heart still can dream. So here's my lifelong wish, my grown-up Christmas list, not for myself, but for a world in need. No more lives torn apart, and wars would never start, and time would heal all. Have a friend, that right would always win, and love would never end. This is my grown-up Christmas list. What is this illusion called? The innocence of youth. Maybe only in our blind belief can we ever find the truth. Christmas list. This is my only lifelong wish. This is my grown-up Christmas list.
We're going to do one more song here for you, and I think on behalf of all of us, I can say it's good to be with friends. The Nazarene world is small, and even though Zach never went to church here, he knows many of you from coming back and forth, and I'm sure some of you have met Jared before, too, and we just want to tell you that we hope you have a wonderful Christmas season. We want to thank you again for allowing us to kick this off with you, and they're going to play a few more tunes in a second, but this is just our little wish for you.
Christmas future is far away. Christmas past is past. Christmas present is here today. that will last. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the
Well, today's been a good way of introducing and entering into the season of Advent, and certainly tonight's concert has added to that. In a moment, we're going to receive an offering and want to give generously to Zach and to Reba and Jared for their ministry to us tonight. If we've been graced by what they've presented to us, we want to grace them by what we give back. And so we're going to ask the ushers if they would to come. If you are going to make out a check, you might want to put in the memo section concert, just so that we know for sure that that's where you intend for those monies to go. And all loose offering tonight will go for the love offering as well. All right, let's bow and pray.
Thank you, God, for everything. Thank you, God, for the things that we need for food and drinks. And thank you for offering tonight all the money and the things that we give to. Amen.
Stand up. We're going to do one more with everyone.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. To the world.
Thank you so much, Reba and Zach and Jared. And I think let's express them a greater appreciation for this evening. Thank you so much. It's a wonderful way for us to begin to get into the Christmas spirit. We appreciate so much your offering your talents and your gifts up to the Lord and to minister to us and share with us tonight. Thank you so very, very much. Don't forget all the different activities in the life of the church this Advent season. Tomorrow night, the choir will be at the Mustang Community Center for the Festival of Trees, or Tree Fest, I believe it's called. 7 o'clock, they'll be singing. There's a lot of other activities going on there. Wednesday night, our young people, it's our Wednesday night fellowship meal. Our teens going to NYC will be serving that evening, so all the funds that come in for that will go to help that. What's on the menu for Wednesday? Chili and cornbread. Okay, so that's the menu, chili and cornbread for the menu for Wednesday night. Come and share in the fellowship time, support our young people. Don't forget, Celebrate the Light, December 12, 13, 14, not this coming week, but the next week. Take advertisements out there off the table, tickets, little invite cards that you can use to give to your coworkers, to the people around you, your neighbors, and invite them to come and share. This next Sunday morning will be our children's program. It'll be a great day. Let's just look forward to all that God has for us in the midst of this Advent season. Let's pray. Father, as we conclude this service tonight, we thank you for the talents of these young people that have said, here we are, Lord. We are available. And they're trusting in you as they go forth each day. Thank you for allowing them to encourage and inspire our hearts, and just to give us a sense of rest as we have heard the music tonight and just have enjoyed being together. And now, Lord, as we go from this place, may we go full of grace with a great trust in you as our Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Have a great week. You are dismissed.
Thank you for watching today online. It has been our privilege to share this time with you. I'm Pastor Terry Armstrong, and I want you to know that if we can do anything to assist you, any words that you would like to say, any comments that you would like to make, or anything that you would like to tell us about what God is doing in your life, please do not hesitate to give us a call. Our number is 405-376-2892. Or you can email me directly at terry@mustangnaz.org. Again, we just hope that today your spirit, your heart has been encouraged by the presence of God. And so now I just want to say to you, may the peace of our Lord and Savior reign and rule, and may He give you His calmness in the midst of your storms. In Christ's name we pray these things for you. Amen and amen.